best of the spirit. Now, what is a teacher doing? Teacher is actually doing this one, bringing out the best in a child. There may be an Einstein in a child. The teacher would bring the Einstein out of the child. And if a child is deprived of a creative teacher, empathetic teacher, there is every possibility that the Einstein might be aborted inside. There is every possibility for that. But if there is a teacher, we can be sure that the Einstein would come out of the person and would contribute to the development of the society. So the art of teaching is bringing out the best of the body, best of the mind and best of the spirit. Once a person was preparing a brick, constructing a, creating a brick, and he was asked, "What are you doing?" He said, "I would like to win my bread and butter for today." Another person was also doing the same thing. He was also preparing a brick, and he was asked, "What are you doing?" He said, I am building a palace." So we can consider teaching in these two fashions, as our breadwinning job or as building of the nation and building of new Einsteins, Bill Gates, new Gandhi's, new Mother Teresa. So that is the greatness of teaching. Now, third aspect of being creative in teaching is aspire for excellence. Now, nowadays in the business field, there is a program of having excellence from the very beginning to the end. From collecting raw materials to up to delivery, and then after the delivery for the service also. So maintain A plus quality from the very beginning to the end. So we teachers should also aspire for excellence. Whatever we do, we should try to aspire for the best. Now Confucius says, what is excellence? What excellence is? The will to win, the desire to succeed, and the urge to reach your full potential. That is the key, or these are the keys to excellence. These are the keys. Actually, these three things are synonymous. Burning passion and desire is